Hey everybody, this is Ori from AstroWeb, and I'm going to talk today about the Shopify inventory and transfers functionality. Basically, we're going to talk about how you manage inventory for the products you're selling and what are the different business requirements or business methods to actually manage them correctly. Okay, so first of all, what is inventory, right? So inventory is an account of everything you're trying to sell, every single product, whether it's a physical product that you're shipping or a digital product which you're delivering, you know, digitally, like you're selling an MP3 or something like that. And in most cases, you actually want to manage the inventory, right? You want to sell a certain amount, unless you have products that have no end, they have no inventory. But we're going to talk about it. So when you go to upload a product, you can specify in Shopify, do you manage inventory, yes or no? So this video is really assuming that you do. I'm going to actually go here in the back end and show you. This is just, for example, a sticker that we're selling in this test site that we made for these videos. And you go here, and first of all, there's the inventory box, and you say, yes, I want to track inventory. And then here you can actually see for every location you have, every warehouse, every location that ships, every store, every warehouse, etc., can see how many. So for example, I have only one warehouse and I have 66 quantities. Okay. So this is our starting point. So for inventory in particular, when you create a product, you go create it and you say, yes, I want to track it. And then for every location I have, every warehouse that can actually store the products or ship it, how many do I have? Okay, really simple. If you want to actually let's go here for a second. If you want to actually change the quantity, you can actually go and either set the quantity completely, say before I had 66, but now, for example, I have 80, or you can actually adjust the quantity and say, you know, I have 66, but I just have added, for example, 12 additional ones, okay, which in total would be 78. So you can manage inventory by going to the back end one by one, edit the product and update that. But usually you don't want to do that because it's really time consuming. So you have a few other options. Let's start talking about the other inventory options. Okay. The other option is the quick kind of bulk changes. Okay. So for example, I'm going to go here and I'm going to go here. So one more thing I want to specify. So in most Shopify sites, or at least most small websites, small businesses, you're going to only have one warehouse, right? So when I go to settings, when you first configure your new store, you're going to have something called locations, which basically you put the location, the address of your specific warehouse. If you only have one, you'd only have one right here. This will help calculate shipping rates, things like that. But if you have multiple, you can add a location, just like I have two locations, for example, and you can specify where they get shipped from. So I just set up two so you can see two different differences. But this video is mostly for beginners, so we're really going to focus on one location, but sometimes I might comment back and forth on multiple. Okay, so this is where these things come. So my first location, for example, is in West Coast. I called it my office number one. My second location, or my second warehouse, would be called East Coast Warehouse. Okay. So now that I go to products, I'm going to go to inventory. And right now I'm browsing my West Coast side. Okay. So just West Coast, for example, I can see all of my products. Okay. And the reason I didn't see them before in the East Coast one is because I just set up a new location for this video and future ones. So now I don't have any inventory in those locations. So if I go here, to my office is the West Coast. I can see products. So you can obviously use the filter. For example, I only want to see the Adidas products. And I can do two things. I can set one by one very quickly. Instead of going to all products, editing one by one, changing the inventory, clicking on save, going back to the next one, I can do it here kind of quicker, right? So I can go here and I can say, hey, now I have 10 and, you know, 10 of these and 30 of these and 30 of these. I want to add to the 10. Let's say two more, right? And it'll show you, hey, you had 10. If you click on save, now you'll have 12, right? If I add five here instead of 30, I have five. I can click on save. Let's click on save. Okay. Or now this add-on is because this add-on box is grayed in, right? So if I click on set, then it's whatever the past inventory was, 10, for example, you're going to just completely override that, say, now I only have two. Okay, so set and add, I think, is pretty self-explanatory. Either replace by clicking on set, or add, which is you're adding, right? Pretty simple. Okay, so this is the second way. This is more bulk, but sometimes you have a lot of products you want to update. So you have two other methods you can do. Number one is you can use a spreadsheet to export and import. So what am I going to do? I'm going to go to my products right here, the products I want, either my entire catalog or some of them, right? So I can click here on export, and I can basically export everything, okay? Or if I remove the search, I can actually export everything I have. Now, right now, I just want to export a few. So I'm going to go here, CDUS, and I'm going to check box, let's say these two, and I'm going to click export and only the two that I selected. When you click on export, you're going to get a spreadsheet. So you can open it in Excel. You can open it in Google Sheets, which is what I like to do. So I'm going to import it into Google Sheets. And now I want to actually replace the inventory. Okay, I want to use a sheet to replace it. So I'm going to open this spreadsheet. And you basically have all of these columns right here, right? The name, the product, the values, the variance, etc. But actually, what we're really caring about, we're not replacing and uploading products. We're not editing products, adding new products. We're only focused on inventory. So everything you have here, you're going to keep it the same. You're not going to touch it. Sometimes you want to use the name just to easily reference, because sometimes the SKU is not easily identifiable. But what you want to do is focus on these ones, okay? Actually, if you only have one location or one warehouse, you're not going to have a K column. So what you're going to do is take a look at, you know, each row is a product that you want to manage stock for. So this product, I have two inventory, and this one I have 30. So let's say I want to change this to 22 and 330. Now, if you notice in warehouse number two, I have something called not stocked. What that means is it's not that I don't have zero stock. I actually don't even want to sell that product in that warehouse. So I type in not stocked, right? So if zero is going to be different from not stocked, right? Hope that makes sense. So now I change this and I'm going to go and click on file and I'm going to download as a CSV, okay? As a comma separated file. I have it right here. I'm going to go back and I'm going to import, okay? And I'm going to go here and just going to drag it and upload. So now if you're uploading a lot of products, so it says, okay, you will be importing two variants. Obviously, I'm importing two. Yes, do I want to? Let's start. Okay, so if you have a lot of inventory, let's say you're updating tens of thousands, it's going to take a little while and you're going to get an email. But for us right now, it's so quick and it's just two products. You saw here, right? 22 and 330. So it already updated. So we finished. That's cool. Now, let's say right now I want to actually bring this product right here. I want to actually allow it to be sold in my other warehouse. Let's say I added stock to my East Coast. So I'm going to go to the products. I'm going to search for that product. I want to make it able to be sold in that warehouse. I'm going to go click here, go to the inventory section. Let's see which product. Yeah, it was this SKU because this is a variant. I'm going to go to edit locations and I'm going to allow it to be sold here. Okay, and let's say I want to update. Maybe I have 55. Okay, now if I were to export, it wouldn't be here stocked. It would look like that. Okay, hope that makes sense. I think pretty straightforward. Okay, so what else do we have? So this is pretty much inventory. The other way you can actually manage inventory, which I'm not going to get into this video because it's very specific and there's so many possibilities, is you could have another software. You could have a third-party app that actually manages inventory somewhere else, and it syncs via programmatic methods, APIs in this case. It syncs the inventory to Shopify, right? Now, there's so many different companies and warehouses that do that I can't cover every possibility, but at least you know you can manage inventory automatically via these other methods. So for example, if you have Amazon FBA, Amazon will track it, and then you can have an app to sync the data. Okay, so this is the first part of inventory. Okay, so the second part is a pretty cool part called transfers. So what is transfers? So you are managing right now, until now we talked about inventory that you manage in your warehouse, okay? The other one is we're talking about inventory that is going to be coming into our store. So for example, if we have a warehouse or we have a factory in China that is making our products, and then we already made an agreement, they're manufacturing them and they're shipping them to us. So if they ship them to us, I can put that information and know that products are coming in. I can track those well. Or maybe we have suppliers, maybe we're drop shipping, or maybe we have partners, or maybe we have other things. So you can actually manage these things. So let's show you some examples. Okay, so I'm going to add transfers. And right now I'm actually adding my first transfer. So let's say I have a factory in China and they just manufactured something for me. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to find some products. Let's say I had a company to actually manufacture my stickers. Okay, so let's go here. And let's say I'm going to add this product to the transfer, okay? And let's say I just purchased from the factory in China. I just purchased, let's say, 90,000 quantity, okay? Now I'm going to specify where's the origin. So the origin, in this case, I can actually create a supplier, okay? So I'm going to create a supplier. I can transfer from one warehouse to the other. That's also a possibility. But in this part, I'm actually going to create a supplier, okay? So this supplier is going to be called China Stickers RS. Okay, I just made up a name. And I'm just going to make Chen Yu. Okay, and I'm going to put their information. So let's just say chinasite.com. Okay, put all their information, Shanghai something something. Okay, street 1234. And I'm just going to make up some stuff. Okay, so you put all their information so you can easily track. And I just made up something, China, and selected Shanghai. Okay, whatever. So now I save the supplier. Okay, so now I have a supplier here. And now I'm going to specify where are we actually ordering it to. So it's coming from China. I'm buying 9,000 stickers. Obviously, I can put more products. But let's browse. Let me say I'm actually ordering a few things. And also, let's say this backpack, I'm also buying, let's say, 50 of these. Okay, so now it's going to go into my specific warehouse. So let's say it's going to go to my West Coast warehouse. Okay, great. And then it's expected to arrive. Let's say it takes 60 days. So it's going to arrive this time. And I can add my tracking number because it comes by boat, for example. And I can select my carrier. Okay, if I don't have one, I can select other and specify the URL. If it's one of these very popular ones, for example, China Post, I can specify the tracking number. Okay, just for example. So now I clicked on add tracking. Now it's here. And now I can also reference my actually purchase order or my actual invoice number, right? So I can kind of match things and I can organize the way I buy products and they arrive. And then when I check my products, I can do that. So maybe my reference number might be some invoice number, some purchase order number, and I can specify tags that I can later on filter and organize. So let's just say these are all the China orders. So now everything looks good. I'm buying these products and I click on save transfer. Okay, so now if I go back here, let's go back to transfers. Now I have a list of my incoming things that I expect to come into my warehouses. Okay, so for example, I click here. And I have these products. Okay, good. Now, nothing actually happened because they haven't arrived yet. But let's assume that they actually have arrived. So what I can do is actually go and say, hey, I just received items and I'm actually going to go to the products. I'm going to open the boxes. I'm going to verify everything looks good. If they look good, I'm going to mark them as accepted. Okay. Now, if they all look good, I can just click here. But if not, I usually want to go one by one. So let's say out of the 50, I received all of them. They look good. And you can see the bar fills up. But out of the stickers, let's say they only ship to me 80,000. Okay, that's kind of weird, right? So I had some kind of issue maybe. Maybe some of them were, they didn't ship all of them, or some of them were damaged and I have some communication back and forth with them. So first of all, I'm going to save it. Okay, so now I received all of these. These are good, but my whole order, my whole transfer is not complete yet. You see right here. Now everything I do will be stored in the timeline. So every time you want to write a note or something, it's good to have track of what's actually happening. I'm going to click back on receive items, and I'm actually going to, I can, you know, in maybe I had, for example, two shipments. I can actually add the remaining, 10,000, right? Or if I had an issue with them, I can go ahead and I can cancel a reject. So for example, maybe I rejected them and I don't know, they had an issue and they're gonna refund me back or something like that. So I can actually specify what I wanna cancel and what I wanna reject. This is for your internal flow, how you communicate with the vendor, the factory, the partner, et cetera, et cetera. So let's say I'm gonna reject these ones. And I go here. Now, when I did this, because I've covered all of my inventory, all 50 here and all 90,000, even though I had some issues, I'm going to put some notes and say, hey, the last 10,000 were refunded because they made a mistake. Factory made a mistake. Okay, so I can do that. I can specify. Now, now I finished it. Now, everything has been marked as received. Before, if you remember, there was a received. Receive button right there. Okay. So now that I have this, okay, so now I finished. It's completed, right? The status is completed. And if I wanted to not be here in this list, I can actually mark them. Okay, sorry. I can mark them as I can archive them. So if I don't want to see it later in the list and I want to focus on the other ones, I can kind of clean it up, right? So it's archived and then I can see, I can kind of mark it. Okay, it's finished. Okay, good. Now, what else do we have? Okay, so inventory. Let's go here. If you remember on the incoming right here, so before we talked about inventory, the incoming right here will actually go and specify kind of from the transfers what is supposed to come in soon. So let me show you an example. Let's make a new one and let's select this product, browse all products. I'm going to search for this one. Okay. I'm going to go here and I'm going to, for example, add, let's say two are expected to come. They're still coming from my China supplier. They're coming to, let's say, my East Coast, for example, expected date, you know, et cetera. Doesn't matter right now. And of course, you know, tracking numbers, everything. I'm going to put that in and I'm going to click on save. Okay. And now if I go to inventory, you'll notice that there's two incoming, right? So I can decide if I actually want to be able to sell them earlier or not. You know, you can have a different business flow. You can, if they're going to arrive tomorrow and you're sure about that, maybe you can sell it, or maybe at least you know that it's upcoming and you can do different promotions, different things like that. So this is just another metric for you to see what's going on. Okay, so you can see, you can click here on the actual transfer. You can see more detail when it's supposed to arrive, et cetera. Other than that, so let's see here. Other than that, I think that's pretty much it. I hope this makes sense for you. This is a very basic explanation. If you have any specific requirements for your business, you're not sure how to set it up, I'd be happy to add some more videos for it, answer some comments, et cetera. Hope you enjoyed this video. And really appreciate your time listening to this video, et cetera. Appreciate it. Thank you very much.